Bill Gates. Bill Gates, the co-founder of Microsoft, was born as William Henry Gates on October 28, 1955, in Seattle, Washington. His father, William Henry Gates II, was a lawyer, and his mother, Mary Maxell Gates, was a school teacher. Gates grew up in a middle-class family with an older sister, Christine, and a younger sister, Libby. His parents always encouraged the children to work hard and be competitive. As a young boy, Gates showed signs of competitiveness while organizing family athletic games. He enjoyed playing board games and was a champion in Monopoly. At the age of 13, his parents sent him to Lakeside Preparatory School. Here came his first exposure to computers. He also met his future business partner, Paul Allen, who was his senior. A local company had offered its computer to the school through a teletype link. In those days, computers were large and took up lots of space, so they were generally owned by large companies. The young Gates became fascinated by the possibilities of the Archaic machine and wrote his first software program, Tic-Tac-Toe, in basic language. Along with Paul Allen, Gates started spending hours in computer room. Hence, they were banned from using the computer. But soon, they found a way out. They offered to find bugs in the computer system in return for permission to use computer. Having got the permission, Gates and his friends computerized the school's payroll system. At the age of 15, Gates, along with Allen, developed Trafodata, a traffic counting system that was later sold to local governments. The program controlled traffic patterns in Seattle and sent reports to traffic engineers. They earned $20,000 for their efforts. So, Gates and Allen decided to start their own corporation. But Gates' parents wanted him to complete his schooling and go to Harvard University to study law. Gates entered Harvard in 1973. He spent most of his time on computers rather than attending classes. Everything changed in December 1974 when Allen read out to him an article about the world's first microcomputer, the Altair 8800. The Altair was made by a small company in Albuquerque, New Mexico, called Micro Instrumentation and Telemetry Systems, MITS. Seeing it as an opportunity to turn his passion of programming into a professional endeavor, Gates convinced his parents to permit him to drop out of Harvard. Gates and Allen called up MITS and told them that they were developing the basic software program that would run the Altair 8800. In reality, they didn't have an Altair to work with. Surprisingly, Ed Roberts, the president of MITS, asked them for a demonstration. Not wanting to lose the opportunity, Gates and Allen worked hard for the next 2 months writing the basic software. Allen traveled to Albuquerque for a test run. It worked perfectly. With the success of this project, Gates left Harvard and moved to Albuquerque with Allen. They planned to develop software for the newly emerging demand of personal computer. In 1975, they started Microsoft by combining micro from microcomputers and soft from software. Microsoft became famous for computer operating systems. In November 1980, International Business Machine, IBM, that was looking for software to operate its upcoming personal computer, PC, approached Microsoft. Microsoft created the MS-DOS operating system and licensed it to IBM. But Gates was smart to keep hold of the right to license it to other computer makers. Following the development of MS-DOS, Microsoft's growth exploded. By 1983, it became global and one-third of the world's computers ran on its software. By the end of the year, Allen left the company as he was diagnosed with cancer, but Gates, leading the way, took the company to great heights. In November 1985, Microsoft launched Windows, an operating system that allowed the user to navigate the screen using a mouse. This was similar to Apple's graphic interface introduced in 1984. However, Windows was not the breakthrough Gates had predicted. Gates worked on improving it. Subsequent versions ran faster and were compatible with a variety of computers, unlike Apple operating system that ran only on Apple machines. Microsoft won the operating system battle and was soon installed on nearly 90% of the world's personal computers. The company saw extraordinary financial success, and being the company's largest individual shareholder, Bill Gates amassed a great wealth. According to Forbes 2019, his net worth is $96.5 billion. Gates wasn't content with just winning the operating system segment of the software market. Over the next few years, he introduced new products such as Windows Office programs, Word, and Excel. The company who introduced new and improved versions of Windows. Gates married Melinda French in 1994. They have three children, two daughters and a son. Gates and his wife formed the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, BMGF, in 2000. The foundation aims to improve healthcare and reduce poverty. Today, this is one of the largest charitable foundations in the world. Gates personally has donated over billions of dollars to charity. In 2008, Bill Gates quit the Microsoft Corporation as chairman and started working full-time on his philanthropic interests with BMGF. His main areas of interest have been improving health to reduce diseases such as polio and environmental issues. Gates has said that he has no use for money and will only leave a small percentage of his wealth to his children. Like most successful businessmen, Gates' success was a blend of his intelligence, hard work, and luck. Throughout his life, he took many risks. He left Harvard to start his own business. Another great risk was when he changed Microsoft's operating system from MS-DOS to Windows. However, Gates was confident of himself in every risk he took and emerged successful.